Hello, everybody. Nero X, the Madman from the Midwest, back again to bless your timeline with another review. And today I will be looking at, drumroll please, Random Access Memories by Daft Punk. Let's go. Random Access Memories is somewhat of a, shall we say, divisive album when it comes to Daft Punk fans. It was released in, unless I'm getting my years mixed up, 2014, I believe, yeah, it was at the Grammys that year. It won Album of the Year at the Grammys, won Best Pop Song for Get Lucky, featuring Pharrell Williams, and I think it won one more, but I could be wrong about that. But it's considered very divisive fans of the group Daft Punk. Now, if you've never heard of Daft Punk, then one, you need to hear of them, literally, and two, they're primarily an electronic French house group. In fact, they helped start the French house movement in the 1990s, in the late 90s. As such, their roots are heavily based in electronic music, primarily drum machines, synthesizers, blah 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 blah. Basically all the stuff old people get mad at kids music for using. Anyway, their third album, Human After All, is a more minimalist and rock-oriented album, whereas the next album, Alive 2007, is an eargasm. Seriously, go listen to this album. And after Alive 2007 was released, which is a live album, we heard nothing but radio silence from them. The group seemed to have gone underground. Until it was announced in about 2010, I believe, that they would be working on their next album using a variety of different people involved, including Pharrell Williams, Nile Rodgers from the group Chic, which is a famous disco group from the 70s, Chilly Gonzalez, as well as a host of others. Random Access Memories is definitely a more pop-oriented album, shall we say, as opposed to the trademark drum machines and synthesizers used by Daft Punk in their works. They use more studio instruments, such as, you know, actual drums, insert the applause playing here, actual guitars, actual basses, and it sort of really, it came off, at least to purist Daft Punk fans, that the group was selling out or fallen by the wayside. But I definitely disagree with that sentiment. It's a wonderfully written album. The songs are very simple, catchy, definitely something you can listen for here. It just makes you feel groovy, man. But anyway. Moving along from that, a definite good microcosm of the entirety of the album are these two songs, Beyond and Touch, featuring Paul Williams, unless I'm very much mistaken. So, if you don't want to listen to the album, you want to get a feel for how the album is put together, listen to the songs Beyond and Touch. My final thoughts on Ram? Well, it cleaned up at the Grammys. I have a good chunk of it on my phone right now as I record this. And it's one of those really one of the best musically composed albums of the last few years. So, listen to it. I mean, I understand why purist Daft Punk fans don't like it. They're sort of like purist metal fans, unless it's not this. But definitely check this album out. Definitely worth it. Give it at least a chance to get all the way through. I personally recommend listening to it while you're driving. Seriously, get to it. Have to be on the highway, and the song Beyond is on. Don't be surprised if you need a ticket. With all that being said, I am Nero X, Madman from the Midwest, back to bless you. Then I bless you with yet another review. Please like, share,